Saved by the Bell is iconic. From 1989 to 1992, the teens of Bayside High defined cool for teens and tweens. But whether you watched the show during its initial run, caught it later in reruns, or only know about the show because of its 2020 reboot, there's plenty about this show to discover. Even if you've been a fan of Saved by the Bell since the beginning of its run, you may not have realized that the high schoolers at Bayside were actually middle schoolers on another show, Good Morning, Miss Bliss. The pilot episode of Good Morning, Miss Bliss focused on Miss Carrie Bliss, played by Hayley Mills, and her sixth grade class in Indianapolis, Indiana. After the pilot, the class was recast and the students were aged up a little. Zack Morris, Samuel Screech Powers, Lisa Turtle, and Principal Belding were part of this version of Good Morning, Miss Bliss, although the show was canceled after 13 episodes. After Good Morning, Miss Bliss was canceled, the show was changed into Saved by the Bell. Mills was dropped from the cast, and the setting was moved to Los Angeles, with the characters now in high school. Good Morning, Miss Bliss was later renamed Saved by the Bell: The Junior High Years. Given Saved by the Bell's already rocky history as a retooled version of Good Morning, Miss Bliss, it's not too surprising that people did not have high hopes when it debuted. As Mark Paul Gosselaar put it in a 2019 interview with USA Today, every season it was like, okay, we had our run and we'll see each other at some point, and then we were always surprised to come back. Even the network didn't believe in the show. As producer Peter Engel explained on the podcast Industry Standard, NBC only ordered 7 episodes, convinced that the Saturday morning show would flop. Engel fought for an additional 13 episodes, heading to the office of NBC President Brandon Tartikoff, demanding either a green light for the additional episodes or for security to be called to throw him out. Engel said, "In retrospect, if I hadn't done that, we'd be 7 episodes and out." Contrary to expectations, Saved by the Bell ended up lasting for 4 seasons, long enough for our favorite Bayside High students to get their high school diplomas. It's hard to imagine Saved by the Bell without Jessie Spano, but the character wouldn't have been part of the Bayside High crew at all if it hadn't been for Elizabeth Berkley. Jessie wasn't one of the characters originally envisioned for the series, but when Berkley auditioned for the role of Kelly Kapowski and lost the part to Tiffany Thiessen, the role was created just for her. Producer Peter Engel revealed on the podcast Industry Standard that most of the people involved in casting actually wanted Berkley to be given the role of Kelly, but he and NBC President Brandon Tartikoff fought the casting department. As noted by Complex, the role of Jessie was created so that Berkley and Thiessen could both join the cast of Saved by the Bell. Clearly, that was the right call. The characters of AC Slater and Lisa Turtle were imagined to be quite different from how they eventually ended up being portrayed on Saved by the Bell. As producer Peter Engel said on the podcast Industry Standard, AC Slater was originally envisioned as Italian. Engel described the original iteration of AC Slater as a street kid and an army brat. They had a hard time casting the role, though, until they opened up the part to other ethnicities. The character of AC Slater, of course, eventually went to Mexican-American actor Mario Lopez. Fashionista Lisa Turtle, according to Engel, was originally planned to be a Jewish girl from Long Island. When Lark Voorhees read for the role, Engel said that the casting team protested, saying, "Lisa Turtle's not black." Engel answered, "Well, she is now," and Voorhees won the part. To kids growing up in the 80s and 90s, Zack Morris was the epitome of cool. Saved by the Bell wouldn't have been the same without Zack, the most popular kid at Bayside High. Who can forget his effortless charm, his trademark blonde hair, and, of course, his cell phone? Fans probably think of actor Mark Paul Gosselaar being just as cool as his Saved by the Bell character, yet he revealed that he was anything but on The Hollywood Reporter's Awards Chatter podcast in 2019. He said, "Zack Morris was a character that I created from seeing the really cool kids in my school. I was not one of those kids." Not even Zack's flaxen locks were the real deal. Gosselaar maintained the golden hairdo with lots of hair dye. So much hair dye, in fact, that Gosselaar told Live with Kelly and Michael that he's surprised his hair didn't all fall out. Samuel Screech Powers may not have had the effortless cool of the rest of the Bayside gang, but his nerdy persona led to a lot of comedic moments on Saved by the Bell that wouldn't have been as memorable if they'd been portrayed by anyone but Dustin Diamond. Screech always seemed a bit less sophisticated than his pals on the show, and it turns out that in real life, he actually was a bit behind his peers, at least as far as his age was concerned. When Diamond was cast, he was actually quite a bit younger than the rest of the cast. Diamond was born in 1977, making him just 11 years old when he first appeared on the show. Producer Peter Engel said on the podcast Industry Standard that he initially had no idea Diamond was so young, admitting that he never would have hired him if he had known. Saved by the Bell may have been a teen comedy, but that doesn't mean that there wasn't a lot of teenage drama both on and off the set. Quite a lot of time was invested in the romances between the show's characters, who were apparently also hooking up in real life. Mark Paul Gosselaar told People in 2009, "All of us dated at one point or another. It was incestuous." Fortunately for the young stars, the details about their dating lives managed to stay out of the tabloids, and the cast kept quiet about the dating scene on set for years. Years after the show wrapped, Gosselaar explained on the Anna Faris is Unqualified podcast that working on the show was like being in a bubble. He explained that as they spent so much time on set and didn't go to school, they didn't have a lot of choices when it came to dating. While the Saved by the Bell cast may have been friends with each other, and even more than friends at times, they didn't always get along. Mark Paul Gosselaar told People that sometimes the girls would, quote, gang up on the guys. The cast may not have actually attended classes, but Gosselaar described the whole thing as very high school. On the Awards Chatter podcast, Gosselaar said that the cast had something of a love-hate relationship with each other. While there were times when everyone was close and got along, at other times, producer Peter Engel would have to step in to help them keep the peace. Gosselaar admitted that some of the fighting was due to the romantic entanglements among the Saved by the Bell cast members, saying, "It was a very small universe that we lived in and that we operated in." Jessie getting hooked on caffeine pills and suffering a breakdown is one of the Saved by the Bell's most memorable moments. The show handled the topic of addiction sensitively, but Jessie's meltdown seemed a bit over the top.
"I'm so excited! I'm so excited! I'm so scared!"
It turns out that there's a good reason for that, though, as Jessie was originally intended to get hooked on speed, not caffeine. As show producer Peter Engel explained in his memoir, "I Was Saved by the Bell, Stories of Life, Love, and Dreams That Do Come True," NBC wouldn't greenlight the storyline, saying that speed was too serious for Saturday mornings. Engel protested, but eventually gave in, swapping out speed for caffeine, even though, as he notes in his memoir, the average caffeine pill is as safe as a cup of coffee. Saved by the Bell was never big on continuity, and the scenarios the students of Bayside High found themselves in often didn't make much sense. That's why it was confusing, but not totally jarring, when Kelly and Jessie disappeared partway through the show's final season, only to turn up again with no warning at graduation. Pop Matters explained that this was the result of the season getting a larger-than-usual number of episodes. Since Tiffany Thiessen and Elizabeth Berkley had already decided to leave Saved by the Bell, they disappeared from the show and were replaced by a new character named Tori, played by Liana Creel. In the final episode, however, Kelly and Jessie are seen graduating with the rest of the class, and Tori is nowhere to be seen. If this has baffled you for years, you're not alone. It turns out that the series finale was filmed before Thiessen and Berkley left the show and before Creel had been cast. When they decided to quit Saved by the Bell, a new finale was never shot. Given the enduring popularity of Saved by the Bell, it would be reasonable to assume that its stars would be financially set for life. While the show did indeed serve as a launching point for many of its stars to go on to lucrative careers, they didn't exactly make a fortune on the show. As Mark Paul Gosselaar explained during an appearance on Watch What Happens Live with Andy Cohen, even though Saved by the Bell entered syndication and has been added to streaming platforms, its cast members didn't make a cent for their roles after the show wrapped.
"We made really bad deals, poor deals back then."
In spite of losing out on what could have been a fortune, Gosselaar didn't seem upset, but instead looked at the experience as a learning opportunity.
"Yeah, right. It is what it is, and you know, you move on, you learn."
While Saved by the Bell may have wrapped in 1992, that wasn't the end of the beloved show. The following year, Saved by the Bell: The New Class premiered, focusing on a new set of Bayside students. Dennis Haskins reprised his role as Principal Belding, while Dustin Diamond joined the cast in Season 2, again playing the character of Samuel Screech Powers. In 1993, some of the Bayside High crew went off to college in Saved by the Bell: The College Years. On the show, Zack, Screech, and Slater went off to California University, where they shared a suite with some new characters. Tiffany Thiessen reprised her role as Kelly Kapowski after the pilot, but Lark Voorhees only appeared in one episode as Lisa. Elizabeth Berkley did not return as Jessie. Series producer Peter Engel regrets introducing new characters on the spinoff instead of focusing on the same teens. He told The Wrap he made a mistake not taking all six main characters to college. Fans seemed to think so too, as the spinoff only lasted one season. It may have been decades since Saved by the Bell wrapped, but the Bayside High crew is still friends for the most part. In 2019, fans went wild when Mark Paul Gosselaar, Elizabeth Berkley, Mario Lopez, and Tiffany Thiessen got together along with their spouses and posted a picture of the reunion on Instagram. Gosselaar wrote in the caption, "This is what 30-plus years of friendship looks like." The gang had previously reunited for a 2015 appearance on The Tonight Show starring Jimmy Fallon, although Lark Voorhees and Dustin Diamond were notably absent. Most of the cast also worked together again on the 2020 Saved by the Bell sequel series. As noted by People, the only core cast member who didn't eventually join the 2020 revival was Dustin Diamond, although that might not be too surprising considering the scandalous tell-all he published about his castmates. Ahead of the series premiere, Berkley said on Watch What Happens Live with Andy Cohen that while she hasn't had any contact with Diamond since the series wrapped, there's no bad blood between them, and that he could appear on the show at some point in the future. Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more list videos about your favorite 90s shows are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.